Hello students, in previous video we learned about the isomers, type of isomers and stereoisomers, and also learn about the two types of stereoisomers, that is geometrical isomers and conformational isomers. Today in this video, we will learn the third type of stereoisomers, and that is optical isomers. Here, the word optics, this word optics is related with light. Optics means related with light. For the detailed study of optical isomerism or optical isomers, first consider the example 2-chlorobutane. Here this is the structure of 2-chlorobutane, and in this structure there are 4 different groups attached to second carbon atom, which can be which is indicated by asterisk, that is star. Here that 4 groups are CH3 methyl, Cl chloro, H hydrogen, and last one is C2H5, or we can be read it as CH3CH2, or also read as C2H5, that is ethyl group. And hence all these 4 groups attached to this carbon, which is indicated by asterisk, are different. Hence this carbon is known as chiral carbon or a symmetric carbon atom. So we also define the chiral atom or chiral asymmetric carbon atom as the carbon atom in a molecule which carries 4 different atoms or groups, called as chiral or asymmetric carbon atom. And when one molecule, any molecule that contains one or maybe more than one atoms, chiral atoms, it acquires a unique property. Any molecule which contains at least one chiral carbon atom, or that carbon atoms may be more than one, then due to the presence of chiral carbon atom, it acquires the unique property. And such molecules cannot be superimposed perfectly on its mirror image. And when we draw the mirror images of that molecule, then the both mirror images cannot be superimposed perfectly with each other. Here this is 2-chlorobutane, this is mirror plane, and this is the mirror image of 2-chlorobutane. And when we withdraw this molecule from here and put as it is to this, here to here, as it is, then we get this type of structure. And this structure or this diagram indicate that there is no perfect superimposable to each other. These both images are not perfectly mixed up with each other. Superimpose easily understand as a mixable. These both images are not mixable. Like, consider this is our hand, And when we put this hand to this, as it is, not like this, but as it is, then we see both are not mixed up with each other or superimposed with each other. This is the non-superimposable. But if we take a glass, this is a glass, and when we put another glass to this first glass, then it is easily mixed up, means superimpose. And this is the example of superimposable images. The another example we can consider when we add one chair to other, then that easily fit with each other, that chairs easily fit with each other, and that is the example of superimposable mirror images or superimposable examples. But non-superimposable means not mixable. Okay, and this property for the compound is acquired only due to the presence of chiral carbon atom, and the molecule which having chiral carbon atom called chiral molecule. Means this molecule is a chiral molecule because it contains a chiral carbon atom. A chiral molecule and its mirror image are not identical every time. Any chiral molecule, and when we draw its mirror image, then both are not identical at any cost. But a chiral molecule and its mirror images both have same structural and molecular formula, but the special arrangement of four different groups or atoms is different. Hence, chiral molecule and its mirror image are stereoisomers of each other. And this relationship between chiral molecule and its mirror images is similar to the relation between left hand and right hand. Here we already explained the example. This is left hand and this is right hand. And when we mix both hands, it is not possible to, it is exactly not possible to adjust both. They are opposite. And this left hand and right hand relationship is applicable for the chiral molecule and its mirror image. Hence, it is called handedness or chirality. Some persons pronounce this as chirality. The origin of this handedness or chirality is from Greek word, that is chair means hand. The stereoisomerism in which the isomers have different spatial arrangement of atoms or groups around the chiral atom is called optical isomerism. The stereoisomerism, because optical isomerism is the type of stereoisomerism and which in which there is different type of spatial arrangement of atoms or groups which is attached to chiral atom, and that difference is in between original chiral molecule and its mirror image. Both, in both the arrangement of atoms is different. Hence this type of isomerism called as a chiral isomerism, optical isomerism. And the optical isomers are differ from each other in the terms of measurable properties called optical activity, and both are optical isomers, means both original chiral molecule and its mirror image, both are different in the measurable property, and that measurable property called as a optical activity. To understand this optical activity, we must know about the plane polarized light. What is plane polarized? Plane polarized light. Here, this is the ordinary light, and we know that ordinary light is waves of ordinary light oscillates in all possible directions. These are the electromagnetic waves. These electromagnetic waves are oscillates or propagates in all possible directions. And if we pass these waves through Nicol's prism, Nicol's prism is made up by calcite, that is the crystalline form of calcium carbonate. One form is amorphous form and another is calcite, that is crystalline calcium carbonate. This Nicol's prism made up of crystalline calcium carbonate. And when we pass this ordinary light through this Nicol's prism, then that waves are polarized and they are oscillate in a single direction only, and this single direction is perpendicular to the direction of propagation of light. This is the direction of propagation of light, and this is the oscillations of wave, and these oscillations of waves are perpendicular to the direction of propagation of waves. They are perpendicular, and this is the polarized light, and it is called as plane polarized light because planes of these oscillation lights are perpendicular to the direction of propagation of light. Hence, means all these planes are polarized by using Nicol's prism, and hence this light called as plane polarized light, that is PPL. Now we should define the plane polarized light by using previous diagram. A light having oscillations only in one plane perpendicular to the direction of propagation of light is known as plane polarized light. Here, this is the previous diagram, and we know when we pass the ordinary light from Nicol's prism, then the all oscillations in all direction present in ordinary light polarize through this Nicol's prism, and they having oscillate in a single plane which is perpendicular to the direction of propagation. Hence this light called as plane polarized light. Now we understand the optical activity. What is optical activity? Now we have the plane polarized light, and we pass this plane polarized light through the chiral solution of chiral molecule in water. Any type of chiral molecule. Here we take a glucose, solution of glucose in water, and when we pass this plane polarized light through this glucose solution, then this plane polarized light, when passing through this glucose solution, it may be rotated either towards right or maybe left. This is rotation towards right. Here this is rotation towards this light. Pass through this, or then this, it may be rotated towards right clockwise, or maybe clockwise, or maybe anti-clockwise, that is on left side. RHS rotation, LHS rotation. And this property of rotation of PPL called as optical activity. Means optical means related to the light. That is light rotation property of any substance present in solution called optical activity. Now turns towards the definition of optical activity. The property of a substance by which it rotate PPL, that is plane of polarized of incident PPL, is known as optical activity. And the compounds which rotate PPL are called as optical active compounds. Here in this diagram, this is the plane of rotation and this is the direction of propagation, and both made angle called theta. Either it may be rotated towards the right or it may be rotated towards the left, it always make a angle theta. Both angle, magnitude of both angle is same, value of both angle is same, but direction is different or sign may be different. Always remember it. The angle of rotation theta of PPL called as optical rotation. This theta called as optical rotation. According to this optical rotation, optically active substances have two types. According to this angle theta, we classify optical active substance into two types, and these two types are, first one is dextrorotatory substance, or it is also known as diisomer, and second one is levorotatory substance or called as L isomer. Here we briefly study or learn both isomers. First, it turns towards the diisomer or dextrorotatory substance or molecule, a compound which rotate the plane polarized PPL, that is plane polarized light, towards right hand side is called as dextrorotatory substance or diisomer, and it is designated by symbol D or by positive sign. If this solution rotate this PPL towards this right, then this substance is always D, or it may be denoted by sign positive, that is this solution may be dextrorotatory. Or if this solution rotate this light towards left hand side anticlockwise, then it is called as L, or it is denoted by negative sign. Now turns towards the L isomer, a compound which rotate PPL towards left called levorotatory substance or L isomer, and designated by symbol L or negative sign, and both are isomers of each other. Isomerism, in which isomeric compound have different optical activity, known as optical isomerism, and compounds are called as optical isomers. Here both this D and L both having different optical activity, both have a same molecular formula, same structural formula, but the arrangement of groups present or attached to the chiral carbon atom is different. Due to the different attachment of groups to the chiral carbon atom, the optical activity also different. Means one isomer rotate light towards the right hand side and another isomer rotate PPL towards the left hand side. These optical isomers having equal and opposite rotation. I already mentioned that both D isomers, the value of theta, that is optical rotation वैल्यू ऑफ ऑप्टिकल रोटेशन इज सेम बट डायरेक्शन इज अपोजिट और साइन इज अपोजिट, वन हैविंग अ पॉजिटिव साइन एंड अनदर हैविंग अ निगेटिव साइन. मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ रोटेशन इज सेम बट साइन इज डिफरेंट और अपोजिट. दिस ऑप्टिकल आइसोमर्स आर ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज इनानशोमर्स एंड दिस इनानशोमर्स फर्स्ट रिकग्नाइज बाय फ्रेंच साइंटिस्ट लुई पास्चर बाय ऑप्टिकल एक्टिविटी. नाउ सी वॉट आर द इनानशोमर्स. द ऑप्टिकल आइसोमर्स विच आर नॉन सुपरइम्पोजेबल मिरर ऑफ इमेजेस ऑफ ईच अदर आर कॉल्ड इनानशोमर्स और इनानशोमॉर्फ्स और ऑप्टिकल एंटीपोड्स. दे मस्ट बी नॉन सुपरइम्पोजेबल मिरर इमेजेस एंड द फर्स्ट एंड बेसिक नेसेसरी क्राइटेरिया फॉर द ऑप्टिकल एक्टिविटी इज दैट द मॉलिक्यूल मस्ट कंटेन एटलीस्ट वन chiral carbon or chiral atom, any atom. There is no carbon, but here we study the organic chemistry, so here we consider only carbon, but there may be oxygen, sulfur also, etc. The enantiomers have identical physical properties only except the sign of optical rotation. Both isomers having a same physical properties, they have a same physical properties, but the sign of optical rotation is different. One is positive sign, one having a positive sign and other having a negative sign. They have identical chemical properties also, but the except condition is that they reacts with non-active reagent, non-optically active reagent. If they reacts with optical active reagents, then the chemical properties of these isomers may be changed. Some molecules does not rotate plane polarized light towards any side, then these molecules called as optical inactive substances or optical inactive molecules. And I already mentioned that for the optical rotation, that molecule must contains at least one chiral carbon atom. And when we mixed equimolar diisomer and L isomer, and we prepared the solution of that mixture and passed the PPL through this solution, then there is no rotation of PPL. Because both isomers cancels the rotation of each other, and due to this it shows zero rotation, and that is called as racemic mixture or racemic modification. An equimolar mixture of enantiomers, that is diisomer and L isomer, is called as racemic modification or racemic mixture. And this racemic mixture is optically inactive. I already told that this is optically inactive because it shows the zero rotation. Why it shows zero rotation? Because optical rotation due to molecules of one enantiomer is cancelled by equal and opposite optical rotation due to the other enantiomer. Means the rotation of one enantiomer is cancelled by rotation of other enantiomer, because even the magnitude of both enantiomers is same. Magnitude of rotation of both enantiomer is same, but sign is negative, one having positive sign and other having negative sign, and due to this both cancelled each other and it shows zero rotation. A racemic mixture or racemic modification is designated by DL or by plus minus sign. Now we see how this chiral molecules is represent in three-dimensional structure, that is representation of configuration of molecules. These methods we already study in previous standard chapter number 14. There are four methods to represent the configuration of molecules in three dimensional or plane of paper. First is Weyl formula, second is Fisher projection formula, or it is also known as cross formula. Third one is Newman projection formula, and fourth is Sawhorse or Adiron or perspective formula. But here, for the representation of chiral molecules, we require only two formulas or methods, that is Weyl formula and Fisher projection formula. Turns towards the Weyl formula. When any tetrahedral carbon molecule is imagined, consider we imagine the any tetrahedral carbon here. This is the tetrahedral carbon, and we imagine this carbon. Then, and we imagine this carbon is present on plane of paper. Then all the four bonds, all these four bonds attached to these carbon atoms are exactly not, cannot lie on the plane of paper. Some bonds are on the outside of the plane of paper, and some are present on plane of paper, and the bonds which are present on plane of paper are called as normal bonds, or they represented by normal lines. And the bonds projecting above the plane of paper are represented by solid wedge, that is bold line. The bonds which are above the plane of paper, consider here we put the carbon. Here we put the carbon. One bond is here. One bond is here. One bond is above the plane of paper, and other bond goes down to the plane of paper. Or we can easily write the structure. Consider this is a plane of paper. Here this is carbon. This bond is on plane. This is also is on plane, but one bond is above the plane, this, and the bond which is above the plane, that represented by solid wedge line, and the another bond is down to the plane of paper, and that represented by broken wedge or broken line. While bonds going below the plane of paper are represented by broken wedge or broken line. Here this is the diagram. Here bromine and chlorine both are represented by normal lines, means both these bonds present in the plane. Here hydrogen is represented by solid wedge, means it is above the plane of paper. Here iodine represented by broken wedge, means it is present at below the plane of paper. Now we go to the next projection, that is Fisher projection formula, or it is also called as cross formula. In this representation, the three-dimensional molecule is generally projected on the plane of paper. And a Fisher projection formula can be drawn by visualizing the molecule with its main carbon chain as a vertical. Consider we have this representation in wedge formula. And now we convert this wedge formula into Fisher projection formula. Then the vertical lines, these vertical bonds that attach to the carbon atom, this carbon atom, then we draw in a Fisher projection formula a single vertical line here. And the other bonds this or cross this vertical line by drawing horizontal lines, and the cross section of both lines, cross section of both line, this point is considered as a carbon or chiral carbon. Here the convention is that horizontal lines of cross represent bonds projecting up from the carbon, and vertical lines representing bonds going below the carbon atom. These horizontal lines indicate us that the bonds are above the plane of paper and below the plane of paper, and these vertical lines represent that bonds are lie on the plane of paper, and this is the representation of chiral molecules in three dimensional by using Wedge formula and Fisher projection formula.